place. But glory be to God. Amen. There was time now with grandmother. She knew when the time was right.
Yeah.
Amen. He saved way on our yard.
Yeah.
And it wasn't bring the net.
Yeah.
Get them ready. She would fly right here, Jehovah.
Yeah, she would.
She would throw them, put them in the refrigerator.
Yes,
yeah. She would refrigerate them maybe for a few days and get them chilled. And let me tell you something. Then that was Sunday morning.
Yeah.
Homecoming.
Yeah.
Lord have mercy.
Oh, yeah.
Like we're here now, we're gathered for the homecoming.
Yeah. Yeah.
And she don't did. Amen. She had to fry a loss of chicken.
Yeah.
Not just one or two, but why she said do five and sometimes it was six.
Yeah.
We'll fix them up.
Yeah.
And that's not to tell you. When eating time will come.
Oh, yeah.
I'm talking, we call it chow down.
Yes. Yeah.
Chow down time will come.
Yes, sir.
When it's always respect.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Amen. From our household.
Yeah.
When it was the church involved, amen, the preacher always went first.
Yes, sir.
And the kids were always going last.
Yeah.
Right, right.
But now I can serve at the church, everybody's eating. I'm the last one coming. People can feel I'm already going out the door. And she called my dad, you better come on in here. That's okay, just let them have it. I got an appetite.
Yeah.
But not that bad.
Yeah.
I said, as long as it's there, amen, I'll eat when I get to it.
Yeah.
But if you just there, just the respect was in its proper place.
Yeah.
And we let no boys, I'm going to get out your way. We're standing out. I said, go on outside and play. Mm-hmm. And then we'll serve the guests.
Mm-hmm.
But it'd be just the preacher's wife. Amen. And there's a few more guests
that'll
be sitting at the table.
Yes.
But let me tell you, didn't worry about running out, Brother Dawkins.
Mm-hmm.
Because they had what we call these platters.
Yeah.
About a foot long, a little longer.
Right.
And then when they fried the chicken, Brother Eddie, amen, it was like the mountain.
Yeah.
Right, right.
Oh, yeah, chicken.
Right.
Chicken is stacked up 6 inches high.
Yes, sir.
And boy, we sit there. And we done played out, we're tired, we're ready to get to the table. And we just kind of go around to the window and just take a little peek through the window. And that preacher, I'm going to get him, Pastor Brian.
Yeah.
He's Pastor Brian.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
We called him Loudmouth Brian.
Yeah.
But when he planted his foot at the table,
yeah.
Amen, the mouth stopped working. And then God was going to allow them, amen, to come in and devour his people.
Yes,
but to make a long story short, and after his prophecy had come forward, and here come a nation a lot stronger than they were.
Yeah, yeah.
Took the houses, took the land.
Uh-huh.
And let me tell you, even the little children were destroyed in that battle.
Yes,
but then God was allowing this to happen. So what he did, he used the enemy.
Yeah.
Amen. In order to get them right.
All right.
Because what they did, rebellion had took place.
All
of God's were served in.
Yeah.
But there come a time when you're in a strange place too long.
All right.
Amen. What homesickness was set in.
Uh-huh.
And I see a people here. They're in a state. Amen. Of mourning.
Yeah, yeah.
The interstate of groaning.
Right.
They were now in a place where famine had set in.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Yeah,
but our hunger had taken his toll.
Yeah.
Here in a wilderness place.
Yes, sir.
were out, they were shut out from Zion. But then you got to look at Isaiah chapter 4 tonight.
Yes, sir.
But if you go back to chapter 4, here from 40 to 66,
yes, sir.
God is sending a message of consolation.
Yes,
getting ready, amen, to bring his people out.
Yes,
and you see, if God, amen, put you out, he knows how to bring you in. If God put you back, he knows how to pick you back up. When you go hungry, he knows how to feed you. If you're naked, he knows how to clothe you. I hear the preacher the other day coming from, I believe, Matthew chapter 6, 5. Six, and you're talking about the provision of God. And he said, now, even God himself, amen, if he so clothed the fowl of the air. Just a little birds, amen. But you are a people of God. How much more God, amen, cares for you. But I hear Isaiah 64, amen, and 10 says, we're going back up to chapter 7. So here they had got in the state where they feel God had left them out. God, amen, was not hearing them anymore. He was not answering their calls anymore. Well, they just said, well, we just might as well give up, amen. God, amen, don't care about us. But Isaiah 64 said he's talking about a coming remnant. Even though he talks about the people of God and the church itself. But amen, he brings in the remnant, which is our Lord Jesus Christ. Because see, you got to remember God, amen, that called these people out. They were a holy people. Chosen by God. But there was time, amen, they had to get the little whooping, we call it.
Right.
God got ready.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Everything was going to work out. But they're saying here, Isaiah 64 and 7, and they're saying, and there's none that call upon thy name that stirred up himself to take hold of thee. For thou hast hid thy face from us and hast consumed us because of our iniquities.
Yes.
But now, O Lord, they're saying, thou art our Father, and we are the clay, and thou art the potter, and we are the works of thy hand.
Thou
reminds me of Jeremiah. Lord sent Jeremiah to the potter's house. And the reason God sent him there, that he may see the works up on the potter's hand. He said, now when you get there, Jeremiah, take, amen, instruction. For I'm going to show you something here. For what you're about to experience is between myself and my people. He said, now the potter that you see walking and walk upon the wheel, and the clay that he has is my people. I am the potter. What I'm trying to tell you, Jeremiah, you see, so his life was in there. To take him out. But oh, God is gracious. He said, now what I'm going to do, yes, Lord, there are people that lightning seems have lost their way, have got no hope in their life. But he said, but now they are broken up. You got these 12 nations. But you come to back. North and the south. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm talking about here's Judah and here's Ephraim. They're divided from the other. Amen, that they're broken up. But the potter is getting ready. We're putting back together again. Hallelujah. You're broken up when you're down. And the people are saying here, said, but now we are what? Very sore. Oh Lord, neither remember iniquity forever. Behold, we beg thee. We are thy people. Thy holy cities are a wilderness. Zion is is a wilderness.
Yes.
Jerusalem is a desolation.
Yes.
Our holy and our beautiful house.
Yes.
Where our fathers praised thee.
Yeah.
It's burned up with fire.
Yes.
And all our pleasant things are laid waste.
Yes.
They said, when thou refrain thyself from these things, O Lord.
Yeah.
When thou hold thy peace and afflict us very sore.
Yeah.
So you see here, as they cry out, amen, unto God.
Yes,
and they're saying, remember us now.
Yes,
oh God,
oh, yeah.
We're in a bad situation.
Yeah.
We're in a bad state now.
Oh, yeah.
Oh God, we're calling upon you.
Yeah.
Right now.
Yeah.
Somebody's calling for deliverance.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. But the Lord is saying, here, back in 49, he said, now I have engraved your palm in my head. You are my walls with ever before me. See, when those want to be remembered, want to be reminded, amen, of those that are close to us. Sometimes, we're biting the braces.
Yeah.
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
Husband, we're biting wives.
Yeah.
Our engagement rings.
Yeah.
These things are there for a sickness.
Yeah.
But God said, don't worry.
Yeah.
I have you on a palm in my hand.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
All you got to do now is have hope. Don't worry. God is coming through.
Yeah.
Hey, forget now. Whatever you lost,
yeah.
I'm gonna give it back.
Yeah.
You lost your home.
Yeah.
You lost your land.
Yeah.
They took the church.
Yeah.
Even your children.
Yeah.
But now,
yeah.
You may be a little far.
Yeah.
But now,
yeah.
I'm getting ready,
yeah.
to enlarge your body.
Yeah.
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 I'm getting ready,
yeah.
to bring you out. To bring you in.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But I feel sad. Shout.
Yeah.
Oh, shout.
Yeah.
Shout.
Yeah.
For the Lord is getting ready to do a new thing.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Yeah.
Shout.
Yeah.
Oh, my people.
Yeah.
Don't worry
yeah.
about what state you're in.
Yeah.
And I want you to know
yeah.
we've come a long way.
Yeah.
Come a long way to go.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
This may be a left. But that's all right. Sick in your body, things not going well. But shout, shout, God is getting ready to do a new thing.
Hallelujah.
No friend with me.
No
witness. I'm trying to close this thing. Yeah. But in that, he want to let them know once they get back into Jerusalem. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Uh-huh.
I was on the other day, Psalm 126.
Hey.
Y'all remember that, don't you?
Yes,
and it said, oh, those that weep,
yeah.
oh God, and rejoice.
Yeah.
For God has
yeah.
done that great thing for thee.
Yeah.
The Lord has
yeah.
done great things for us.
Yeah.
Well, then again, I can't believe it.
Come on.
Oh, Lord, let us feed in the south. Thank you, God, for it. Shall rejoice and be the shoe.
Yeah,
that's why they can rejoice. But beyond that, God has done great things for us. Yeah, he's so good. He even do great things for the enemies. But he'll do better things for those his people. Good days have gone for those that I love the Lord, that I call according to His purpose. Yeah, I'm getting out of here. I feel all right.